Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm explaining some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview, like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. In Angular interviews, you may get a question, what is the difference between pure and impure pipes? That is what I am going to explain in this video using an example. I have created an Angular application in which I have a top and a bottom component. This is what I am rendering in the app component. In top component, I have an input box in which I am getting the student name and then I am displaying the mark if the length of the name is greater than 0. And I have a button to update the mark. In the TypeScript component, you can see that. So here, when I start typing something, we can see the mark is getting displayed as 98. And when I click update, it is getting changed to 33. In bottom component, I have a search variable and a fruits array. In the update function, I'm adding a new fruit, apricot. If you see in HTML, I have a text box to get the search text. And then I have a div. Inside that, I have two divs, left and right. In both the divs, I'm using ng4 and showing each fruit. Finally, I have an update button to add the new fruit. So now this will not work. But if I click update button, we can see the new fruit is getting added. Okay, this is my code setup. Now coming back to top component, right now if I type some name, mark is getting displayed. But my requirement is to show whether the student is pass or fail. So I'm going to create a pipe to achieve this. Let me open the terminal and I can use ng, g, p and a pipe name. Let me give it as result. Result pipe is created. Let me change this according to my requirement. If value is less than 35, let me return this. Else, let me return this. Now in the top component HTML, I can use this result pipe and pass the name as argument. Now if I type some name, we can see Surendra is pass, got 98 marks. And if I update, we can see Surendra is fail, got 33 marks. So this is working. Let's move to this section. Here my requirement is, I need to show all fruits in the left. And when I type some text, I need to show the filtered fruits in the right. For that, let me create a pipe. This time, let me name the pipe as filter. Okay, filter pipe has created. Let me change that to fulfill my requirement. I'm going to return the filtered value which starts with search text. Let me also return the original value when the search text is empty. Now I can use this pipe in the HTML. And I can pass this search text as argument. Let me test this. When I type AP, we can see only apple in the filtered fruits. Let me add the new fruit, apricot. We can see it is added in all fruits, but it is not coming in filtered fruits. Here if I type something and update, it is getting changed. But here it is not working like that. Let me put some console logs to make it more clear. We can see when I update, the result pipe is getting executed. But when I update here, the filter pipe is not getting executed. Why is that? To understand that, first we need to understand the difference between pure and impure pipes. A pure pipe is only called when Angular detects a change in the value or the parameters passed to a pipe. An impure pipe is called for every change detection cycle, no matter whether the value or parameters changes. When we create a pipe in Angular, it is going to be pure by default. In result pipe, when we update, this value is getting changed and so the pipe is executed. But in filter pipe, this value is not a primitive. This is an array. And on update, we are not changing the value. We are just pushing a new value and so the array is still pointing to the same reference. Therefore, there is no change in the value and parameter. That is why the filter pipe is not executed on update. If I change the search text, we can see the new fruit is displaying. That is because now this parameter is changed. But if you have a requirement to show the new fruit on update itself, we can mark this pipe as impure, like this. Now if I type AP and click update, we can see it is displaying. But when we use impure pipe, we need to be little careful because impure pipe will execute for every change detection. Let me show that. Let me clear this, and if I click inside and click outside, we can see this filter pipe is executed. If I update here, we can see this filter pipe is executed because this filter pipe is impure pipe. And so this will execute for every change detection. So we can use impure pipe only if it is really needed, and we need to make sure it is not going to impact performance a lot. For our requirement, instead of using impure pipe, we can address that in a different way. Let me show that. First, let me change the pipe back to pure. Let me go to the component. Here, after I push, let me use slice to copy the fruits to a new array. And so this reference is getting changed. So the pipe will execute. Let me test this. This is working. Like this, we can avoid using impure pipes. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.